That's it.
Castle doesn't need guns.
working in the pump shed over there. Are you with the Atom Cats?
Meow.
Oh, I'll take that as a yes. So is that pump all fixed up now?
Yep, should be all fixed.
You guys are great. Thank you so much. Maybe someday this will do the farm some good. The Atom Cats have been such a great help to us. You must be hungry. Here, take some food back with you. And please, send Zeke my thanks.
Hi.
I don't think I've seen you around here.
I'm scared.
You're really fine.
Sort of. It's complicated.
Well, that's none of my business. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why set up a farm at a place like this? It might not look like much. And there's that smell. But that's the thing. See, this used to be a sewage plant. The most fertile soil in the Commonwealth is right under our feet.
No wonder your crops are doing so well.
That's Commonwealth ingenuity for you.
Yeah, they really are. I have to admit, I feel lucky to even be having this conversation. We fell on some hard times not long ago. A pack of super mutants hit us. Wrecked our entire crop. Used to be Minutemen would have helped us out, but last I heard, they were too busy fighting each other to worry about us farmers. So we were on our own. All of us starving, near to death. No man should have to watch his wife and children suffer. You know what I mean?
Those days are over. The Minutemen are back, and we won't let you down again.
No offense, but I'll believe it when I see it. Anyway, feel free to have a look around, yeah? We got some stuff for trade, if you're interested. My wife June handles that. The kids are Jamie and Wally. They're always curious about visitors, but they should stay out of your way. It's been real good talking to you. I hope you'll come see us again sometime.
Roger.
June's a heck of a mess. I feel no shame.
All right.
You're...
Huh.
help.
Sec.
Do you have a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
When we first met, I admit, I had my doubts about you, but you've done nothing but impress me. You're just who the Minutemen needed to bring us back from the brink.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from you.
You've probably realized by now how important the Minutemen are to me. When I was a kid, the Minutemen were my heroes. They were the only good guys around, really. When I turned 17, I joined up with Ezra Hollis's company. He was one of the good ones. Really believed in the old-time Minuteman way. We had a few good years there. I felt like I was part of something bigger than me. Like I was really helping make the Commonwealth a better place.
It sounds like you were really making a difference.
I think we were. I know we were. But obviously it didn't last. I'm sure there was a lot I didn't see or know enough to pay attention to. You know, the politics and rivalries and bad blood between the different groups. I guess General Becker was able to keep a lid on it, keep everyone more or less on the same team. But after he was killed, it all came out in the open. I couldn't believe it at first. These guys were supposed to be Minutemen. They were supposed to put their duty to the people ahead of everything else. You probably think I was pretty naive, huh? I guess I was. Still am, too. Even after everything. I still believe that the Minutemen can be what I always thought they were. The good guys.
We are the good guys.
We're doing our best. And a lot of it has to do with your example. So I guess what I'm trying to say is, thanks. Anyway, I appreciate you taking the time to listen.
Anytime, Preston.
Thanks. We'd probably better get back to it.
Robert Cooper. Bobby, we discussed this. You hooking up with your stepsister is your own friggin' business. But you talk in your sleep. Look, maybe you babble about baseball or sing show tunes. Or, could be you chat about those three bodies Colin O'Malley dumped in the sand trap of Arlington Greens. You want to take that chance? I know I don't. Sorry, Robert. The girl's gotta go. Eddie Winter, signing off.
Nice.
Oh, there we are.
All done?
Yep. You're gonna have to give me something harder than that.
That was just the first test, Buster. Don't get big-headed.
That place was a real dump, huh? Thanks for taking care of our business there.
June sends her thanks.
Ooh, that June is a doll! And her Meyerler cakes are the most far-out thing I have ever tasted.
Just so you know, I will be checking your work. The cats won't take credit for shoddy craftsmanship.
So she had the skills to spiff up the Warwick pump. Should we rustle her jimmies with something else?
Crap! We got gunners coming in hot! Gunners!
Out of gas!
gunners! Those wet rags keep trying to get their mitts on our suits! It's you, Jack? You slayed! Because of you, we didn't lose a single cat today.
It was no big deal.
No. You are out of sight. And a friend of the cats in my book. You have full reign of our digs. And, you know, I can get you hooked up with a little discount around here, yeah? Finally, the holy grail for anyone who knows what's cool in the Commonwealth. Your very own Adam Katz jacket. Wear it well, Jack.
You wear your plates with style.
Jack?
We could use a few more suits around here.
Someone in there?
Let me out!
Who are you?
What does that matter? Just let me out.
How did you end up in there?
I hid in here to get away from the bombs. But there isn't a handle on the inside, and it's really dark in here.
The bombs were over 200 years ago. You're that old?
I don't know how long I've been in here. A long time, though. A really long time. Please, I don't want to die in here.
Okay, okay. I'll let you out.
Yes. I've been stuck in here for so long. Hurry up. Shoot the door off.
My legs are so stiff. Everything's so different. I guess I was in there for a really long time. What do I do now?
I'll take you someplace safe.
I just want to go home. I want to find my mom and dad.
Then let's go find your home.
You'll be safe with us, Billy.
Thanks. I live in Quincy. Or at least, I used to. But I don't know how to get there. Everything's so different. It's all blown up.
Whoa, it's nighttime and it's still kind of bad.
All right. It was always pitch black in the fridge.
Cute kid. Is he for sale?
What? Never.
Yeah!
Your loss. You change your mind, bring him to my camp.
Or...
Mom? Dad? Are you in there?
Billy! Billy!
Son? Is that really you?
It's me. It's really me.
Oh my God! We thought you were dead.
What happened to you? You're all burned up like me.
We're ghouls, Billy. The radiation changed us. Looks like it did the same thing to you.
Don't worry about it, Billy. Your dad and I don't care what you look like. We still love you.
I love you too, Mom. I missed you guys. It's been so long.
Thank you for bringing us back, our little boy. And saving us from that man.
Yeah. I'm glad we found you.
Here. Take this. I wish I had more to give you, but we don't have much.